Yeah, hello. What's up, bitches? Ward-Kovalev 2. Ward-Kovalev versus Ward 2. It depends who you think won the first fight, of course. I think Kovalev did, but anyway. Ward is the official winner, so his name must there come first. Yeah, first of all, there was some talk that the trainer of Kovalev, John David Jackson, had gone over to train Ward. It showed to be just just rumor, as far as I've understood, because some say that it was just to get the pay-per-view numbers up, for a second match, because they were fearing that because Ward didn't perform really that well in the first one, that they would they would get less pay-per-views anyway. So yeah, here it says that that Jackson tried to jump ship, or there was a this unboxing scene. There was a seems to be just a rumor, as I said, and here it says a few weeks ago there were industry rumblings of potential issues between, and this is from May 29th, yeah, between Cole and head trainer John David Jackson. The most shocking of the rumblings was a claim that Jackson was considering the possibility of jumping ship to work with Ward. It was really, not so surprising, because Kovalev has been involved in some controversy regarding racial issues, like before also, with Adonis Stevenson. He's trying to get a better lightning. With Stevenson, he called, or didn't call him a monkey, but he alluded to that because he, yeah. Anyway, you know that. Let's not go into those dirty details. So it was, I guess it was always kind of a stretch for Jackson, who is an African American, to work with Kovalev, who may or may not be slightly racist. So or maybe he's just stupid, that's another possibility. I think even more likely, because if he was really a racist, I don't think he would pick a black man to train him. Do you? I don't think so. But it was more like, he doesn't know better, that stuff. So this fight, what will happen in this fight? Well, there are, as always, several different ways it can go, but I guess Kovalev, he may even get a decision this time, but he may have to score a knockout also in order to win, because if the fight is close, as it was last time, you know, it may be hard to get that decision because, but it has happened in the past. For instance, when Malinagi fought Baby Bull Diaz, he was robbed in the first fight, and then in the second, which was, I think, more or less the same as the first, Malinagi got the decision. So, the boxing establishment knows how big a figure in the fighting world Kovalev is, you know. So I don't think they would, if he really won again, I don't think they would dare to rob him, because that may mean that, you know, he can retire, you know, out of the disappointment, because he has, apart from Stevenson, who has been ducking him, he has beaten everyone so far at light heavyweight, except Joe Smith Jr., but he may not, well, he has really had a good last year when he knocked out first Fonfara in one round and then Bernard Hopkins in eight. But he has a fight coming up against Sullivan Barrera. So if he wins that fight and wins impressively, then it surely means that he deserves a shot against, you know, either Kovalev or whoever wins Ward, or, you know, or even if Kovalev should not win, you know, a fight between those two would be pretty logical, you know, because both are big punchers, both very exciting, you know, exciting fighters to watch, action fighters, and, you know, very strong and all that. So, you know, I'm not gonna waste any time on trying to predict exactly how the fight is gonna go. So, I guess, you know, it will go pretty much like last time, but I think this time, one thing, Ward has now fought Kovalev, so he now knows what he can expect, and I think he can perhaps prepare himself better for this fight. But on the other side, you know, your skills as a technician and your defensive skills can only take you as far against a guy like Kovalev. You can never be sure, you know, of winning against someone like him, because he's so capable, and I think he made a mistake perhaps in the first fight, because he thought, I knocked him down, I'm ahead on the scorecards for sure, you know, I can take a few rounds off, and, you know. So I guess he didn't, perhaps, I'm not saying for sure, but perhaps he didn't gun hard enough for a knockout. So, because he knows that Ward is tough and a good technician and all that. So, yeah. But again, Kovalev will surely also train very hard this time as well, and now he's hungry for revenge, and maybe we can, you know, we are in for a big knockout, because Ward has never been knocked out or down before Kovalev did it. So if Kovalev can put him down, I think that he can put him out as well, don't you? Yeah, it remains to be seen, because, but I think, anyway, it will go likely, you know, like, at least 8 rounds for sure. It will not be an easy fight for either guy, of course, and yeah. I just hope that whatever happens, that the right guy wins this time, because that didn't happen last time, so... of course, someone in the American boxing establishment, sports writer or two, will always be on Ward's side, you know, the home guy. So, yeah, that's about it. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.